Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy. Welcome back to more Xenoblade Chronicles. Last time, oh boy, we got a lot done. We returned to Machna Forest, built a bridge to connect the two regions there. Went back to Colony 9 where we got a fourth skill tree for Shulk. Who knew there was such a thing, right? Not only that, but we saw a heart-to-heart between Ryan and Dunban, which directed us to come here, to Colony 6. This time, we're going to be doing some work at the Reconstruction HQ and getting Colony 6 back on its feet a little bit more, because it's been a while since we've been here. Now, just letting you know, we could have technically come here and reconstructed some things as early as Machna Forest access, but now that we've cleared the High Ancia Tomb, we're able to level everything up to at least level 2, so personally, I think that's for the best because there is a really cool reward for getting everything up to level 2. So, as you see, I've started off by leveling up housing to levels 2 and 3. This doesn't really do a whole lot for the colony aside from just build some new roads and place some houses along them. Not a whole lot of people living here yet, though. Raising commerce to level 2 is going to get you a new shop opening up over by the Reconstruction HQ, and okay. I don't mean to be super negative, because I did wait a lot longer to get this store than I could have, because the items for this were available as of Machna Forest, which was a while ago. But even with that in mind, even if you went and got that as soon as possible, the items you get here, you have no slot weapons that focus on block rate and physical defense. You have some decent light armor with no slots, some heavy armor that's really obsolete, have the same thing really on every page, and the only real thing of note is that you have a lot of art books for Dunban, some of which I've already purchased, as you can see by that owned thing up in the corner. You have randomly one art book for Charlotte here. I guess she kind of is from Colony 6, so that kind of makes sense, but all in all, kind of a disappointing store aside from the art books. Commerce level 3 is going to open up this road a little bit further and open two new stores on it. Atharon will also move down here. We'll need to think ahead if we want to attract more people. They'll be needing places to live, work, not to mention relax. So, I say two more stores because one is open during the day, the other is open at night, and I don't get it at all. This first store. We have some one-slot weapons that are, again, kind of obsolete. Keep in mind, you could have opened this after clearing the High Ancia Tomb, which is something that we just did in terms of progress, so it's just like... These weapons, keep in mind also that just from playing the game, I have like multiples of all these weapons. I didn't buy these at all, I just had them in my inventory already. The cool armor is here, which oddly has Blaze Defense 3, and the next area that we're headed to, according to Alvis, is a snow-covered mountain range, and you should expect a tough climb. So, no go on that. If it was Chill Defense, maybe, but it's not. We got two pieces of heavy armor on every page, which is kind of a strange thing if you ask me. And, as for art books, we have a lot of assorted ones. I only chose to buy, Mind Blast from Melia because it was the only one that really stood out to me, and this kind of brings me to something. The shops in Colony 6 kind of suck. I really hate to talk that negatively about them, though, because you do kind of have to go out of your way to get these, but for how much work you have to do to open these shops, they're kind of trash. I have never used the equipment in them. They are always such laughably weak equipment, even when I go out of my way to get them as soon as possible. And honestly, it's probably my least favorite thing to level up in Colony 6 because of that. In fact, this nighttime store that opens up right nearby, they sell pretty much the exact same weapons, only worse. They sell the exact same armor minus the second piece of heavy armor. So they have a worse selection of armor than the other one and have the same items on the items they actually do carry. And then they have the same selection of art books, but with a few missing. I don't get it. What's the point? It's just... I hate to sound so frustrated, though, but it's like, for how much work you have to do on commerce, it's just like, you get so little in return, and it's like, you can't really just not do it, because you have to level up everything in Colony 6 to a specific level to get the rewards, and it's just... I don't know. It feels so much less rewarding than all the others to me. If there's something I'm missing about these stores, please let me know, but on any playthrough I've ever done, the items in the stores always sucked, even if I got them as soon as possible. Upping nature to level 2 will get you these flower gardens on the side of the street that we were just on. These don't really do much of anything, they're just completion percentage, but they are a stepping stone to nature level 3, which is a really big deal. We can't do that yet, but when we do, it will give us something really nice. And then special level 2 is going to build us this Armu farm that is to the north of that flower garden we were just checking out, and I can't really- there we go, I jumped the fence. And we got these two farmers right here. Boy, come on, wake up. We've now got a farm where we can keep armus. Upkeep won't be easy, but we need the armus for the colony. I'll be getting advice from the expert beside me as I try. Alright, what do you have to say? This kind young man is always thinking of others. He even takes the time to consider the old has-beens like myself. So, what exactly does the Armu farm do- Okay, Ricky can jump the fence even though it's twice his height. What exactly does this do? Well, it's a special level up, so you will get item orbs that give you items from various places all over Bionis, not just Colony 6. So, two Shoral Mushrooms, I wonder what the odds of that happening are, I mean, getting the same item out of how many possible ones can appear, that's crazy. With the completion of the Armu farm, everything is at least level 2, meaning that we get a reward, of course. And when we got everything to level 1, we get an EXP up 1 gem, so I bet you're expecting an EXP up 2 gem, right? No! Loves to go one step beyond and give you an EXP up 3 gem! It loves to play with your expectations! Oh man, well, okay, in all seriousness, if you're struggling with a boss fight or something like that and you haven't been doing as many quests as I have, this can be really helpful in a pinch. However, there is one other thing that I want to bring attention to. When you reach 15% completion, something is going to happen. As you can see, when we talk to Juju, we have the Aether Planners malfunctioning. Well, why is that? I got this surprise quest when we got to 15% completion. There are Mechon attacking an Aether Planter, and thus it is causing the quality of the Aether Crystals gotten from this area to not be as good as they could be. So, we need to get to that ASAP because nobody messes with my crystal mining. I've gone ahead and switched up the party a little bit in the span of that cut, and I want to put things into perspective a little bit. According to that quest, there is a Mechon attack going on that is attacking the Aether Mine, similar to what happened last time. Nobody is taking cover whatsoever, the whole town seems completely unaffected by it, and yet, somehow, Mechon just being here is affecting the quality of the Aether Crystals. In fact, there is the Aether Planner we need to go to right there from the main entrance. The Mechon are just kind of standing there. I don't know how they're disrupting the quality of the Aether Crystals from just standing there so easily, but hey. We got three Mechon. Oh, wait. Guys, come back. Okay. I forgot something. There is something that I really need to show off. Thing is, during that montage a couple episodes ago, Melia learned a new art. We haven't really been doing a whole lot of fighting, so I haven't really had a good chance to show this, but I'd like to do so right now. So let's switch Melia in. We'll have Shulk as a side party member. And this is... Oh, boy. This is one of my favorite arts any character learns. I want to re-equip a Spear Break. Let's get rid of Summon Wind. And then I want her new art, Starlight Kick. I will get rid of Hypnotize for this. And, well, why is Starlight Kick so good? Why? Let's find out. Spear Break knocks the enemy back, inflicting slow. It's a melee attack, so you do have to be close to be able to use it. Starlight Kick. If used after Spear Break, it forces Topple on the enemy. Yeah. If an enemy is immune to Break but not Topple, Melia can just bypass the Break entirely and topple them anyway. This is, without a doubt, one of, if not the best Topple in the entire game. Not only that, but you know how Melia's got to use discretion between buffing the entire party and discharging her elements to do high amounts of damage? Well, after Topple comes Dazed, and if the enemy is Dazed, no aggro is generated, allowing Melia to just spam without consequence. This is hands down one of the best arts of all, like I said before. It is so helpful, makes her so much more powerful, and once you have this, oh man, is she amazing. But this kind of brings up a new problem with Melia, and I hate to criticize her on something because she's such a good character. It's that her AI is trash, quite frankly. If I can say that, her AI is not programmed to look to see if you have Volt Spear Break and Starlight Kick equipped, meaning that it will never intentionally use that topple. It's just blind luck whenever the AI actually does use it. I've had entire playthroughs where the AI seemingly never did it once, but I've had others where it did it often enough, I guess. The other problem is that the AI is not really programmed to know like when the best times to hold onto an element are and when the best times to discharge it are. So you kind of have that problem as well. Her AI is so bad. It's to the point where I would say Melia is one of the best characters if you play as her, but she is near useless if the AI is controlling her. It's really a shame to say that because I like Melia a lot and she is one of my favorites to play as, but her AI is just so bad. I'm sorry. I mean, I would dare say that other than Sharla, she probably has the worst AI. Anyway, I don't mean to ramble on about that. Let's just get our Aether Crystals now that the Aether Planters have been repaired, and believe it or not, that is the only quest I wanted to take care of in Colony 6. Now, I want to head back to Eryth Sea, of all places. Some people might be asking me why I want to head back there, considering we were just there and I finished up a lot of things. Well, there were quests that I wanted to tackle there that open up after Prison Island is completed, but I just, or rather even the Hyantia tomb, but I kind of wanted us to have a little bit of change of scenery because we'd been in Eryth Sea for like 10 episodes at that point. And, you know, just kind of go around the world, show some other places. Besides, the quest that I want to do here shouldn't take us too terribly long, but oh boy, are they cool. Trust me on this. I cannot wait to show just how cool these quests are. While we're on our way there, we do need to go to a new area in Eryth Sea, and we need to go north from Central Seal Island up to, I believe, Hovering Reef 10. And while we're there, something that I want to mention about Colony 6 is that there's that mechanic of recruiting people from other areas of Vyanus to move to Colony 6. I haven't really done much of this yet because, just simply put, I don't like doing quest chains until we can complete them all the way through, most of the time at least. I mean, Desiree was kind of an exception to that last episode, but you know what I mean. Most of the time, I like completing an entire chain of quests right in a row so it's easier to follow in a video form. But there is not a single quest chain that is open from recruiting people that we can complete yet. So I don't really want to recruit anybody just yet. We will be doing it soon-ish, but not on that visit to Colony 6. Anyway, new area, Aether Plants. This is, I guess, presumably where the Hyantia get their futuristic clean technology that powers their entire capital that we humans are too ignorant to use, or I guess Homs in the context of this universe. You can see all these turbines spinning, you know, it's one really great big giant windmill. But there is one windmill that is not functioning whatsoever, rather, I guess, four windmills, because there are four turbines spinning. And we have one person here with a quest for us, Jarek. You transported over here from the lighthouse, didn't you? Did the lighthouse manager tell you about the problems there? Well, we've got our fair share of problems over here as well. Some Hodes attacked and damaged one of the turbines. That doesn't sound good. It is indeed a problem. Do you think you could help me? Then I'll be able to get to the lighthouse. Do you want us to help fix it? This is an amazing machine. I'd love to learn more about it. It must seem amazing to your people. Wow, sick burn on the Homs. But it is not a recent creation. It has been here for a very long time. Wow, way to call us friggin' cavemen. Hyantia technology is also fascinating. It still looks brand new and works perfectly even after so much time. Although it is broken now. I have two problems I would like assistance to solve. First, I need you to help repair the wind turbine. Then, I want you to punish the Hode leader responsible. Are you willing to help? We have trouble at the plant. There are multiple quest objectives, which are another quest, punish the Hodes. We have to defeat Funeral Gazra at the Hode Refuge in Eryth Sea. And then, mend the plant. Collect three pieces of luxury Hode wood from the Hodes in Eryth Sea. We've been fighting a lot of Hodes already, so it wouldn't surprise me if we already have those items in our inventory. Let's just see here. I mean, we believe we can succeed. No problem. Leave it to me. And we get some affinity between Shulk and Melia. Awesome. Yes, yes, yes. We all like that. And sure enough, we have all the items in our inventory already. We can just talk to him again immediately.
Yes?
You've collected all the materials we need? That was quick. Yeah, quick is right. We did it in a negative amount of time after you asked. Just slot the planks in place and it should work. Wait a minute. So the Hodes broke this thing. And we gotta slot in the parts. This whole thing is made out of wood. The Hyantia really are advanced people. I mean, we got like broken glass here with wires. We're just gonna slot wood into it. And boom. There we go. It's powered again. Heck, we even like made like a monitor light up. The Hyantia really are freaking advanced people if they were to make all this out of freaking wood. I mean, I know that it's like luxury wood or something like that, but still, wood is wood nonetheless.
Yes.
Wood is wood, words of wisdom. The wind turbine seems to be back in perfect working order. We've completed mend the plant, but we must now punish the Hodes. So, we need to go to the Hode Refuge at Eryth Sea. Where is this place? Well, it is right nearby. We jump down here. Wow, that was weird. And, Shulk is about to have a lot more guts than I think I ever will. Geronimo! I should have taken in a longer breath before I did that. So we have this island right over here. This is indeed the Hode Refuge. And as you can see, if you look closely below the water, it seems that this was a floating island at one point among the other floating reefs, as it doesn't connect to the floor of the sea. It just kind of is a buoyant giant piece of rock. Kind of a shame that it's no longer floating, as having a floating volcano-looking area would have been really nice, but I guess not. I mean, think of how colorful and creative the locations are in Xenoblade Chronicles. They'd have, like, a floating island with a volcano on it, and the way that, like, the magma would be flowing up into the volcano from the surface of Vyanus would be that there'd be, like a pillar of magma just coming out of the ground, flowing up into the island. Oh, it'd be so cool! Or rather, it'd be so hot, rather. I don't know, I'm just being weird. But you know what I mean. It would be a really cool creative location. It's kind of a shame that out of all, like, the tropical volcano areas, this one's just kind of in the ocean like the ones in our normal boring universe. So, in this area, there are Hoads and Arluga everywhere. I don't believe that any of these have any items that we could use for the future, or rather for any quest that we currently have that needs us to get some items. I believe that's only a Magna Forest. We have an Echidna there that's pretty high level, and it probably will see if you swim too close to it, so keep that in mind. Over here, though, through the water, that is where Funeral Gazra is. I need to start a battle with that before it sees me, though, but I can't... I really do wonder if it's possible to actually start a battle with this without getting noticed. I guess maybe if you had, like, an Earthcloak gem on, you could... But it just, like, it's kind of annoying. All the time, I always have that same problem where it's like I swim up to it, I try to be careful, but it always notices me first. Funeral Gazra has some really mean spike attacks, so I really need this Monado Purge to get built up quickly. You know what, actually? I could go back. I could do Stream Edge to hit multiple targets, and there we go. Kind of sucks I'm not going to be able to do that daze on it because I was a little bit too slow on it, but oh well, we'll do the Monado Purge. There we go. And that's done. Should be pretty good from here on out. I don't really feel it necessary to show this fight. I mean, this is a level 42 monster, which is a little bit strong, but it's nothing we can't deal with. All done. We have a lot of hosts to deal with. Ooh, I got an achievement, Charitable Ally, and I got my first skill on Shulk's new skill tree. Awesome. On the subject of achievements, there were actually two that I got in some montages a couple episodes ago, and I wanted to make note of those. I got Clearing the Air... And I got Elementary. You'll see on screen right now what exactly that means, just because I think it is kind of necessary that I bring that up. Don't want to skip over any achievements, and I did almost forget, so good thing I got that right here and now. Let's finish this. We'll just absorb some of its health. And wow, that didn't do as much as I thought with the times 2 multiplier. There we go. Dunban gets it done. It's over. Bad. And we mustn't be careless. Now, the cool thing about this area is that we have some item orbs here. Actually, quite a few of them. But what's kind of a shame is that there, to my knowledge, is no skip travel point on this entire island, and I think there's going to be other quests later that are going to have us coming back here. I mean, it is nice that we can skip travel to the Aether Plant anytime we want, but we can't go to the Hoad Refuge, and it just like, yeah, it doesn't take that much swimming from the Aether Plant to get to it, but who wants to do swimming? Seriously, it slows you down, and it just takes forever. I don't get it. Wait a minute, Jarek, where are you? Hold on a minute, he's back here, isn't he? All right. Dude, if you want us to do quests for you, don't go changing locations on us. I'm gonna switch up the party a little bit because I don't think Shulk really needs all that much more affinity.
Yes?
Yes, it appears that you have done everything I asked of you. The wind turbine is once again working perfectly thanks to you. I could hear the Hoad leader's death cries all the way from here. I won't have to worry about him anymore. I hope I was of some help. Yeah. I will try not to let those Hoads do any more damage. I am so glad I turned to you for help. Why do I get the feeling we're gonna have to deal with basically being somebody's hitman? Got shell gauntlets and good footing. Hold on there. Can you hear that? What's that flapping sound? Sorry, I gotta hide. Take care of those things. We got two confusion echidnas there at sea to deal with. I am going to bet that they are right behind me as soon as I turn around.
That's what I'm talking about.
Ooh, Ryan. That was funny. I was like, I'm gonna bet they're right behind us. That's what I'm talking about. Wait a minute. Level 37? Are you serious? Okay. This is not a case of me being over-leveled. Not even close. We just fought a level 42 unique monster, and they're just throwing level 37s at us? Are you for real? Okay, this is kind of funny, let's be honest. We'll do a Spirit Break, and let's see if the Starlight Kick works. Okay, no, it was immune to the topple. There are some enemies that are outright immune to topple, so it won't force it on them just because they have an outright immunity. So it isn't quite as completely foolproof as you might think, but it is still a really damn good topple. Wait a minute, what? Melly is, like, shooting Rhine. What the heck? Why is she shooting? Okay, hang on. Let me do this again. Let's watch. Yeah, she is shooting Rhine with that. Why are you hitting Rhine? Like, the enemy's, like, I guess kind of close. Oh, we got the Art of War. Okay. But yeah, why are... Yeah, she is attacking Rhine with that. I mean, like, I get that, like, the discharge is, like, wearing off because, you know, we're discharging the element, though. But it's just, like, yeah, she is not shooting the Echidna. It is flying... Let's discharge the Summon Flare. Oh, wow. That was painful. I'm sorry, I'm just like, this is kind of weird, I'm not gonna lie.
Flawless victory.
But we mustn't be careless.
Man, what a bunch of jokers.
three really great end of battle quotes all at one time. Kidna Jaw Gristle, that sounds really creepy. Now, Jarek, as he ran away and fled like a scared little girl, he is, believe it or not, under the ether flat now, hiding behind a rock. So how about we go over to him and just see what he has to say?
Yes?
That was terrifying. They were really out to get us. They must come from more like they were out to get me, because they didn't even know that, like, you did that. Yeah, supposedly natural, you did kill their leader. It's a good thing you were here. If I was by myself, those things would have eaten me for sure. Right, I'm going to repair the lighthouse. Thank you for everything you have done to help. I hope I was of some help. Don't worry, you were a great help. Seerith Lighthouse will be in danger if I don't go soon. I must hurry. So, that was an okay quest, I suppose. We didn't really get, like, amazing... Well, actually, we kind of did. We got Buff Time Plus 2 and Divine Protect 2. Buff Time Plus, pretty self-explanatory.
Father,
Divine Protect, I don't quite remember, unfortunately. You'll see what it is on screen, I guess. That quest, believe it or not, is actually very important. Upon completing it, we can go back to the lighthouse and there will be something new for us. This is something you really don't want to miss. Like, you really, really do not want to miss it. Where is that, anyway? Right, Hovering Reef 4. I've been there only, like, 12 times already. Of course I forget. So, we'll go up into the lighthouse. And upon reaching the top, we have Shaylin. Is Jarek not here? Is it just Shaylin? I thought it... Oh, Jarek is here. What does he have to say? The repairs didn't go anything like how I thought they would. Of course! I guess it's no surprise. It'll be a long time before the lighthouse restored. Great. All those airships that are not flying in this area are likely to crash into the capital without a lighthouse. Let's talk to Shaylin. Hello? You are Hyantia, aren't you? I am. Sorry for asking such a silly question. You're certainly a cute one, but you look like you can handle yourself. There is no need for flattery. What is it you want? Oh, you must be shy. Do you know the job of this lighthouse? Of course I do. It serves to suppress the activity of monsters at Eryth Sea. Oh, okay, so it's not the same purpose of normal lighthouse. That prevents them from attacking Alchemoth. It is a very important installation. You're right. Everyone knows the lighthouse has some problems recently. So I asked Jarek to... Why are you acting so nervously? That's not important now. It will take quite a lot of time to repair. If any monsters attack, we'll be completely helpless. I see. I suppose we could protect you all until the repairs are finished. That's an excellent idea. Are you sure? So we're just gonna fight every monster in Eryth Sea until he's repaired it? That sounds like quite the job. We have to fight three Decay Echidnos at the Seerith Lighthouse, excuse me. So, it is already nighttime. I think we're pretty good there. And right on cue, there they are. Wait, what? Wait, oh! Oh, it's in here! Crap! Okay, let's fight. That was kind of funny. I didn't even notice it was right on top of me until after it started doing damage. Okay. I would be terrible in war. Camera, okay. I apologize for the camera making it kind of hard to see. I can't really help that. It's just like the camera in here is not really the best because it keeps hitting against the pillars. So I'm kind of having some trouble getting this right. Let's do that. I think I just... Oh, whoa. Dang. I know that Mind Blast looked really cool, but damn. I could not like see a thing during that. That just coated the entire screen thanks to how the camera's being. I mean, I can't even see Melia at all. I'm just kind of... What? Wow. And then... What is even going on my screen right now? Holy crap! Just look at this! It's just a complete mess! Maybe I'll just take out one and then just cut the rest of this fight, because this is gonna be like... Seriously, if I can barely even tell what's going on, I doubt somebody watching would be able to tell what's going on. Sorry about this. Let's just finish off this Decay Echidno, please. Die, please. There we go. Jeez! I had to show that because that was really cool. Wait, what? I can't move. No! Don't go! No! What? Okay. Okay, that was weird. That battle just randomly ended for no reason, and I got swept away by the teleporter, thus making it so I had to come back up here. Did that not count? Did that not count? I can only see two chests. Come on, where are you? Nope, it's back to full health. That did not count. Wonderful. Thanks, game. Dumbit! What? Where'd he go? Where is he? Dumbit! Oh, wait. What? This area is really bugging the game out. I should not be having this many problems with this one fight. Oh, it.
Man, what a bunch of jokers.
But we cannot be reckless.
I think I lost the treasure chest to the sea. Wonderful. Okay. Well, that entire quest could have gone a lot smoother, and I mean a lot smoother, but we completed it nonetheless. That is the important part. Let's talk to Shaylin once again. Yes, they are grateful. You definitely should be after how much I went through. Lighthouse is already repaired, so much for it taking a really long time. I should trust someone who knows how important it is. Splendid. I am glad we could be of service. The lighthouse once again has all four of its lights. Hopefully, Eryth Sea will be a little safer from now on. I am extremely grateful for your help. Think nothing of it. We simply did what we had to. I have one more thing to ask of you. I expected as much. What is it? I'd like you to thank Jarek for me. You can tell him yourself. There is no reason to be reticent. I think that's how that's pronounced. I can't. If there is no reason to be reticent, then can you not tell him? Why me? You should tell him yourself how you feel. I decline your request. I understand. You are reticent as well. Do not speak as if I am like you. I am not reticent. Can we stop saying that word? It is just that I am unaccustomed to doing such things. You have to get used to it at some point. You must not go through life always hiding your true feelings. I said I am not reticent. Hehe, good luck. So Melly is all like, I am not reticent. Why would you say that I'm reticent? Because I'm not reticent. And then the game is like, psh, you are reticent. Skill branch unlocked. This will improve ether defense by 5 if you equip it, which I think I want to do right now. Rather, let's see what we're missing out on. Grants immunity to ether down to buff. That's nice, but I don't really think I need it right away. Reticence. Palace Guard improves block rate. Heavyweight Expert improves ether defense more when heavy equipment is worn. Unadorned Beauty. Strength, Ether, Agility, and HP up if no gems are equipped. I don't really think I'd use that, because the gems really are just too good. Mental Barrier reduces damage taken from Ether area attacks. That's not really nice, considering how much she kites the enemy. And Arcane Aura reduces aggro when aura is active. Not bad at all, actually. That is not bad. Wow, down by 30% as well. Shoot, what exactly do I want to do here? I think I will just go for Reticence because it is the newest one. Let me just make sure that there's nothing that I'm missing from the other ones that I might want. Actually, looking at it, even though I got this fourth skill tree that has some really awesome stuff on it, I think I better go for Serenity just because I like the skills that are on this tree a lot more. We'll go for Reticence next after that one is pretty much maxed out, though. Anyway, sorry about the cut there. I just spent a little time looking for something, a lot longer than I would like to admit, and I wanted to talk to Shaylin, and I couldn't exactly find her again. She moves out here after you've completed and is just, quite frankly, staring at this really amazing view. Who could blame her, right? Let's talk to her. Thank you for your help last time. Everything is back to normal thanks to you and Jarek. The lighthouse is at its most beautiful with all four lights. We should take a good look at that whenever we get a chance next. How about we talk to her again, because I love what she says the second time. Eryth Sea has become much better since you all arrived. The transporter, the ether plant, and now the lighthouse as well. Maybe you have someone watching over you. It's technically possible to have her say that before you have completed Prison Island, but personally, I just kind of like seeing it after that, because you know what she's referencing. Everyone knows what she's referencing. Now, I would like to get a view of the lighthouse, because we did get a pretty good view of that turbine being repaired at the ether plant, but we can't really get a good view of the lighthouse unless we walk a little bit away, so how about we do just that? There we are. I think this shows it off quite nicely. But with all that Colony 6 reconstruction done, this line of quests in Eryth Sea finished, and Melia having unlocked her fourth skill branch, I think that's going to do it for now. Next time on Xenoblade Chronicles, we're going to be heading around the world of Bionis a little bit more and taking care of a few more side things to make our final preparations to go to Valak Mountain. See you guys then.
Thank you.